Hey, hey, it's Tamara here. Welcome to another episode of Making a Farm Simulator in Unity, or Making HayDay. In this video, we will develop a timer for all your processes in the game like building, growing crops, etc. It will have a nice countdown and a slider, just like you see in the game. And also a skip button so the player can finish the process early. Interested? Continue watching. The thing is, almost every process in HayDay takes time to complete. Because it is a simulation, things take time to be produced or built. For this, you'll need a timer. In HayDay, you have a slider pop up when you click on an object that currently has some kind of process going on. Another way to show it is by displaying a countdown text. No matter which way you choose, it's basically the same system. In the game, we will have a timer component which will be added to every object which starts a process. In addition, we will create a timer tooltip, a static object which will pop up every time the player wants to see the timer. The player also has the opportunity to skip the timer with a defined amount of currency, which we will implement as well. I've already made a tutorial video on this topic, but I was too early on in my YouTube/development journey, so it wasn't exactly a good way of doing this system. Now, let's get to the tutorial. Just a reminder that we will continue developing the same project, so if you haven't watched the previous episodes, I highly recommend you do so, because there will be some parts of the video that will involve already written scripts. But even if you haven't followed through the series, don't worry, this system is quite isolated, so you shouldn't have any problems implementing it in your own game. Also, all the scripts are available on my Patreon page, if you want to skip writing them line by line. First thing to do is to create a timer script. Open it in the editor. Create a public string for the name of the process the timer corresponds to. It has a get and a private set. Next, create a bool is running with a private set. Start timer, which is a daytime, time to finish, which is a time span, and a daytime for finish time. Also, create a Unity event for the timer finished event. After this, create a double for seconds left with a private set. Create a public int skip amount and in the get calculate skip amount based on some kind of formula, based on how much time there is left. For example, I wrote total minutes left times 2. Since this script inherits from mono behavior, it should be added as a component to an object. In this case, we won't be creating it with a constructor. We're going to initialize this instance. Create a method which takes a process name, a daytime for start, and a time span for time it takes to finish the process. Initialize the corresponding properties of the timer with these best values. Finish time is calculated by adding a time to the start. And don't forget to initialize the event. After this, create a start timer method. See the total seconds left by getting the property total seconds from time to finish time span. Also, set the bool is running to true. In the update, where our timer is actually running, write an if statement to check if the timer is running. If so, check if seconds left are more than 0. In it, subtract time delta time from seconds left. In else, invoke the timer finished event. Set the seconds left to 0 and bool is running to false. This means our timer is finished. After this, create a method called displayTime. It will return a string with a time countdown. We will display two numbers at a time. So, if we have days left until the process finishes, we will display days and hours. If we have hours left, we display hours and minutes and so on. I'm writing a bunch of ifs to check for these things. And in the else, I set the string to finish because there is no time left and the timer has finished. Return text string. Next, create one small method called skipTimer. In it, set seconds left to 0 and finish time to daytime now. Timer is ready, but we actually have no way of viewing it at the moment, so let's change this. I have created a prefab for a tooltip. You can already put it in the scene since it is going to be the only one in the scene. It has a transparent panel for background for closing the tooltip view. Timer tooltip is actually a slider. Don't forget to set interactable to false. We also have text objects for name, time display and also a skip button with skip amount and currency image. Now, create a script called timer tooltip. First of all, create a static instance of the tooltip because we will need to use it as a static object. Create a field for the timer. write a serialized field for the UI camera. Next, write serialized fields for Tooltip UI. They will hold all those objects that I showed you on the prefab. After this, create a bool countdown. In the awake method, initialize the static instance with this. And also disable the parent object of the tooltip. We will attach the script to the tooltip slider, so by disabling the parent, we're disabling the whole panel with the tooltip. Now, create a method showTimer which accepts a game object caller. First of all, get the timer component from it. Check if it is null and return if it is true. Set the name text to timer's name, set the skip amount text, and also set the skip button active. This is because when we skip or timer is finished, we disable the skip button. And we want it to be visible when we have the timer running. Now, save the position of a caller game object minus the position of the UI camera. Convert this position to a screen point, but before it, call the transform point method on the UI camera and then pass the result to the world to screen method. Transform point method converts the position from local space to world space. And then the world to screen, well, transform a world point to a point on the screen. Set countdown to true and set the panel object to active. This is our parent object, as you remember. Next, let's display the time. In the fixed update, check if the countdown is true. In it, set the slider value. It equals to 1 minus the ratio of timer seconds left and the whole time to finish total seconds. Call the fixed update after we set the countdown to true. This will ensure that we have the UI initialized when the timer shows up. After this, create a few methods. Skip button, onEnoughCurrency, which accepts event info, and onNotEnoughCurrency, which also accepts event info. In the skip button method, add listeners once for both events, enoughCurrency and nonEnoughCurrency. Create an instance of the currency change event, pass the skip amount with a minus and a currency type. Queue this event with an event manager. Next, in the method onEnoughCurrency, call timer to skip it. Set skip button to false and remove the listener for a nonEnoughCurrency event. In the method onNotEnoughCurrency, remove the listener to an event of enoughCurrency. After this, write a method to hide the timer. In it, set the timer tooltip parent object to false, set timer to null, and countdown to false. After this, create a static method to show the timer and call showTimer on our static instance of timer tooltip. Write a static hide method the same way and call hideTimer. Go back to the editor, attach a timer tooltip script to the slider, which is called the same way, and fill in the fields. Also, override changes to the prefab so all the fields you set here will be saved. Go to the tooltip background panel and add a component called EventTrigger to it. Add an event time pointer down and initialize it with tooltip's hide method. Now, when we touch anywhere on that panel, the tooltip will be disabled. Go to the skip button and connect the skip button method to it. Next, we have to actually create a timer to show it. Create a building script, open it in the editor and make it inherit from a placeable object. In the placeable object script, retype definition of the place method to make it a virtual one. In the building script, override this method. Call baseplace method, then add a timer component and save it in the variable. Initialize it with name, daytime now, and the time span with 3 minutes time, for example. It can be any value that you can set on the prefab or anywhere else. Call start method. I accidentally made it private, so I needed to make it public. Add a listener to the timer finished event and destroy the timer component. You can do something else here depending on the process. Create a method on mouse uppers button. In it, call the showTimer static method. Go to the editor and add a building script to the building prefab. Don't forget to initialize the size, of course. Now we're ready to test. Drag an object from the shop onto the map, tap on it, and there you have it! A timer tooltip showed up. If we click on the skip button, we can see text that the timer is finished. Also, if we view the hierarchy, we can see that the timer component has been destroyed. If we create a new building, you can see a timer because it is not yet finished. And this is it for this video. Don't forget that all the files will be available on my Patreon. Check out the previous episodes of Making HayDay to start developing the project from the beginning. Thank you for watching! Like this video if you enjoyed it and subscribe to my channel if you want to see more content like this. I want to thank all my patrons who are supporting me and welcome Daniel Williams. Join the Discord server if you want to chat with me and other game devs. And see you soon! Bye!